Hello, everyone, all who are in one body of Christ. Our Savior welcomes to this joyous community together. Today, I'm meditating upon ask wisdom over everything and seek for the wisdom, not wealth. Proverbs 23:25. Before we start, Jesus Christ talks about this topic. Matthew chapter 6, verse 33. Seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all things will be given to you as well. Now let's see what we can learn from the verse you just read. The most misunderstood proverbs are the proverbs that talk about being wealthy and receiving worldly joy in the form of earthly riches. Lazy hands make for poverty, but diligent hands bring wealth. These proverbs might be the one that is most misunderstood. It is often interpreted wrong, and sometimes misquoted or explained references poorly. That Solomon is saying that wise people always get rich and poverty can always be blamed on the people's foolishness based on their own efforts gaining worldly riches. As a matter of fact, Proverbs 8 verse 18 shows that Lady Wisdom promises with me our riches and honor, enduring wealth and prosperity. But as we've learned in early discussions and devotionals, Proverbs are just guidance on how to live life in God's world, and they are not worldly promises or techniques that tell us how to achieve the worldly prosperity. While it's often misrepresented truth that wise people always get rich and foolish people become poor, that's not always guaranteed. Yes, I agree that if we work hard and diligently, we receive the rewards. But again, we are not living in a just world. Oftentimes, crooked people who know how to work with the system and play with the loopholes, they steal the worldly riches more than the wisest. But that worldly riches always opens the door of evil spirits and leaves its side effects, and throws people in a way of their miseries. Solomon understands that poverty is not always a choice, but often the fault of crooked people taking advantage of loopholes in the system. He also knows that foolish people still get rich, even if he believes that wealth will soon disappear. The understanding of wealth and poverty in Proverbs is nuanced even while it holds out the idea of generously compensating hard, wise work. But the most interesting thing Proverbs says about money is that it's not enough. Our money is always under threat. Whether from market forces or ransom notes, money carries a unique burden. Besides that, money can't save us from natural disasters, stock market crashes, wars, or the death of loved ones. Money is not enough or the pursuit of happiness, so we shouldn't wear ourselves out trying to get wealthy. A wise man named Edgar asked God to give him neither poverty nor riches. Edgar recognized that both too much wealth and too much poverty are dangerous. Wealth makes it easy to forget God, while poverty makes it easy to dishonor him. A helpful way to summarize everything Proverbs says about money is this. Wise people don't look for money. Wise people look for wisdom. And as they receive wisdom, they will have the satisfaction in spirit. Wise people don't run after the things that decay. They look and pursue what is everlasting and grows. Pursuit of joy is in wisdom. The wisdom that was with God the Father before he created the universe. In 1 Kings chapter 3, we find the story of Solomon where he was given a choice. He can receive any gift he wants from God, but instead of choosing power and money, he chose wisdom. God responds to Solomon's request for wisdom by giving him what he asked for, but also the gift of wealth and power he didn't request. That's the whole teaching of Proverbs applied to money. Get wisdom, and she will exalt you. Embrace her, and she will honor you. This is also the teaching of Jesus, speaking to a crowd of people anxious about their next meal. He tells them to seek first his kingdom and his righteousness, and all things will be given to you as well. Food is not enough. It is always under a threat. Even if Jesus fills people's stomachs, they will be hungry tomorrow. Which is exactly what Jesus says after he feeds 5,000. More important than food or money is the wisdom Jesus offers. Jesus left his home in an infinite abundance and wealth to live and create a kingdom with us. To most people, it's foolishness to trade a position in God's palace to die a servant's death. But Jesus' willingness to give up everything ensures that anyone who trusts in the wisdom of his poverty will become rich in his kingdom. It will always seem like we have neither enough money nor food, but when we look for and believe Jesus' wisdom, we get the riches of Jesus' resurrection. This message also gives a promise today. The promise is, get wisdom, and she will exalt you. Embrace her, and she will honor you. Let's close time in prayer together. Please join me in this prayer. Dear Lord, Heavenly Father, mighty, wonderful God, Lord, I know that often a lack of faith in your promises of provision have caused me to seek after the things of this world by myself. I confess this is a lack of faith in you and pray that the eyes of my heart would be focused on you from this day forward. Enable me, Lord, so I can always look towards having you in me to be wise and choose to claim my inheritance in you rather than being foolish to live a life as a servant of sin and death. In Jesus' holy name, I pray, amen. Have a blessed day, and if God's going to talk to you tomorrow.